Charlie with SwordOfSurvival.com. Today's episode is I'm gonna cover the importance of personal hygiene while you're out in the wilderness surviving or camping or whatever. Today, one of the plants that I'm gonna cover is the yucca. The yucca plant can be used for many variety of things while you're surviving: cordage, fire making, shelter making, food, and also soap. So today I'm going to demonstrate how you can take the root of a yucca plant, which I'm going to use the soap tree yucca, to make soap where you can clean yourself up, you know, especially like if you've been out trapping and skinning wild game, you have, you know, contaminants on your hands, you need to clean your hair, your face, whatever. I'm going to show you one possibility of keeping yourself clean. So since my cameraman's not here again today, I'm going to be doing my own camera work, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I got over here and then go from there. Okay, what we have right here is a yucca plant. It's not very big, it's a small one. They're easier to dig up. You can still get just as much soap from the root. This one right here is still in the ground. And then once you get down to the root, it'll look like this. The big old brown covered root with the fibrous and white inside with your material you're gonna use for soap. The root contains sapiens, I hope I pronounced it correctly, that will sud up, causing the suds for the soap. At one time or another, they're using the same root here for root beer, which causes the foam on the top of the head of the root beer to cause it to foam up. So I'm gonna go ahead and set up in a little area here, and then I'll give you the demonstration. Okay, what I set up here is a little area. Got me a little container full of water. I have my yucca root here. Don't really need this top part right now, but you can hang on to this to make basket material out of. Use this to make your cordage. A lot of good stuff. So I'll put that to the side. What I want to focus on is the root. What you need to do is just shave all the outer barky material, the dark brown stuff, covering the white inner fibrous area here. And then basically, you can shave off a couple pieces here. Like so. You can even help it out. You can already see there's little juices inside here already. It feels kind of soapy. What I like to do is pulverize it up just a little bit more, being careful not to hit your fingers. You can do this with a stone, piece of wood, whatever. Next thing I do is go ahead and get it wet. Kind of mush it up with your hands. Rub it between your hands to get it all soaked up like that. And as you can see, I have a handful of suds with just that little bit of fibers, and the fibers itself can also be used as a type of cleaning rag or sponge or scrubber, whatever you want to use it for, to help scrub all that blood and dirt and whatever you might have But look at that. Just like soap. Makes nice shampoo. A lot of people that's used it on the hair said to me the hair nice and shiny. The Indians used to use it for help prevent dandruff, help prevent hair loss. There's also properties within the root and the leaves that they even use to help fight pain like arthritis, bruises, and things like that, which I'll cover later on in a couple more posts, but there you have it. Doesn't smell too bad either. Okay. Now I realize if you're traveling on the go to get out of a situation, you may not have time to dig up your own roots and do this. But if you do have the time and have the water available to do it, there's no reason why you can't, you know, keep yourself clean while you're out in the woods. This is Charlie with SwordOfSurvival.com. I hope you learned something from today's episode. Stay prepared, stay alive. Good day.